What's up, guys? SS here. I want to do a quick little review on the newest in the Predator NECA series. Got the latest three figures, the two Dutch and the original Predator, the water emergence version. Alright, guys, so pretty much this is what they look like. Just picture the clamshell. Get a cool picture in the background of the Predator. In the front, you get what they are and a picture of them. And on the sides, obviously 25th anniversary, which is awesome. One of the sickest movies ever. Gotta love it. And then on the back of the package, they're all the same. You got a picture of the figure. Little bio on the movie, and it shows you all three figures which are available. And that's pretty much it for packaging, guys. Been waiting for this for a while. Definitely cool. Love it. If you want to check out the first three, which are beautiful, just as awesome, maybe a little better depending on which ones you like, check out my review on them. I did like maybe a month or two ago when they came out. Alright, let's check these guys out. Grab what I like to call mud version. Comes with a lot of goodies, this one. A lot. You can see here, comes with this torch. Got a nice little translucent flame going up there. Really a lot of details in these little things. I'm loving it. Just look at that. Pretty sick. So he's got, like I said, a lot of accessories. He's got that. This, he already comes wearing it. Remember in the movie, he's got the match there and the leaves with the powder. And he comes with his bow that he made there, which is really nicely detailed. Look at that. Looks nice. For what the figure is, I mean, $15, $17 figure, depends where you get it. This piece is a nice little string. It's not hard plastic, but cool details. On the back, you could play with it and, you know, you can get these things to stay on, but these are the rest of the accessories. And let me grab him. You know, he's gonna fall. Well, maybe not. Alright, so. He's coming with a lot of goodies. So, in total, you get, what, three arrows. The spear. The other arrow that he attached kind of his grenade thing to. And this other one. Really nice detail on all of them. The spears got a cool little tips to them. I just like that they threw in, you know, they paid attention to the movie. Get the little string there, attaching the knife. Really cool. And let me show you how long the spear is. So it's touching the floor. Pretty much up to there. The tip of his neck almost. Pretty long. Pretty cool. So like I said, you saw in the beginning, you could just use that little string right there and tuck them all in, play with it a little, and they'll stay. Got some cool little poses off of him. Let's check out some quick details on him. Really happy with the head sculpt. I like it. I kind of do wish, though, that they would have given us this head with him screaming, like when he's standing on the tree screaming out for the Predator. But they did a really cool job. Nice job on the eyes, the mouth, the hair. Everything looks cool. You could 100% tell that's Arnie. Look at that. All the leaves, mud and dirt on there. The articulation on these figures is awesome. It's just great. Look how nice and dirtied up the camo pants are. You can see the little stitches. You can see how it's not as dirty in certain spots to make it look a little more realistic. Boots, all nice and weathered. And the back is not as dirty, which is kind of cool. I like it. So you got the ab crunch, really great articulation with this thing. The hair is all nice and muddied up. Did a really cool job on this sculpt. I'm liking it a lot. You got a little bit of blood detail right there on his mouth. Really cool. I'm impressed with this. You know, for $15. Look at the leaves. They look cool. The little match sticking out there. Alright, so that's what I like to call Mud Dutch. Got the veins going on there. His big muscle. It looks like it might be a little more blood there. I'm not sure. But pretty much that's Jungle Disguise Dutch. Looking cool. Badass. Loving it. And let's take a look at Jungle Encounter Dutch. Alright, so pretty much like the last one. The only difference here is the head sculpt is a little different. He's got a couple more, like a different frown line going on compared to the one we got before. But 100% Arnie. Great detail there in the beard. The eyes, really cool. So a big difference with this is he's got the vest on, but no shirt underneath. The other one, he had a shirt on. But pretty much the same accessories. You get the M16 here. I believe it's an M16. Sorry, guys. I'm not into guns, so I really don't know what it is, nor do I give a shit. But you get that. You get a nice pistol that you could pop in there in the holster. And on the other side here, in the sheath that you get, his knife did a cool job. Even the sheath looks nice and weathered. Pretty cool. And you can see, just like the other one, good job on the stitching. See the pockets nicely detailed. Really impressed with the camouflage paint jobs on these. That must be a bitch to paint all these little different colors. Tedious shit. Boots, nicely weathered. You get cool articulation down there. Nice ball joint at the bottom. So let's take a look at the details in his arms here. Pretty cool. A lot of veins detailed out and the muscles. The vest, pretty much the same thing as the last one, just a darker color. This one's black. And it looks cool. Very movie accurate, to me at least. Pretty cool. You got all the little details on the belts. Got the two belts going on there. Pretty cool. Take a look at the back of them. This kind of looks ugly a little, but no biggie. I'm not going to be looking at it from the back. The gun, nice and weathered. I like it. The little strap here. It's nice. It's soft rubber. The vest is not sculpted onto him, so you could take it off if you wanted to, I guess. I'm not gonna. Head sculpt, once again, 100% Arnie. They did a really, really sick job with the likeness on these figures. That's just, for the size, these are really small figures. It's just great. Look at the detail in there. And his abs, just sick. How you get all that detail? A little bit dirtied up there. Unless that's, no, that's not dirt. That's probably just fucking NECA. Always get some fucking paint rubbing off. So, that's pretty much him, guys. And last but not least, you get the Predator. Water Emergence Predator. Just like from the scene where he just gets all muddied up. He pops out of the water, and pretty much the same sculpt as the previous ones we've had. Just he's got, it's not coming off as nice on the camera, but these blues, they're really, really cool blues. And he's painted, but he's also translucent in a lot of spots. You got these that still articulate, his blades go in and out. Got all his trophies. I do wish they would make these strings a little smaller. But he's very translucent in a lot of spots. Got the blue going everywhere. Make it look like his suit's malfunctioning. Pretty cool. You guys have seen him. He's the same thing as we've had before. The only accessory he came with was this one right here. You get a little trophy skull. Great detail in that. Just look at that. That's pretty cool detailing for such a tiny thing. All around, the little cracks in the back. Other than that, you get his blaster cannon. You have to put that on. But you get the cool little dreads. That's it. That's gonna be it, guys. I'm definitely happy with them. They're cool for the price. You can't go wrong. So, give you guys one last look. This is probably my favorite one. It's just so different. You can definitely see. Nice and dirtied up. Great job on the sculpt. Alright guys, just wanted to give you a quick look at these. Check out my review on the first three that came out already. And I'm sure they'll be available at Toys R Us or something real soon. Okay guys, I'm out of here. SS out.